teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Now, Deion Lewis to return. Oh, look at the shoe. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them kind of kicking off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. He's got a man complete. A big play there for the Patriots. 31 yards.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted. I mean, make it routine. How about that throw right there?
Yeah, that's
not a great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Then you gunned down a few guys.
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
So the offense has a first and 10. They squad Gronkowski outright. Going on first down is Brady. Oh, and he'll just get rid of this one deep. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on to the second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Let's take it inside his own 40. Oh, he slipped right by him. That's a net of 40 there. Punt of 48 and a return of 8. And that will come the offense as they take over. Here comes the Bears defense now back out onto the field. And the interception the last time, their third takeaway of the game, Charles.
They're just blocking to the football so well. And not only are they doing that, they're making big-time plays and taking it away from them. Big hits, big plays. They're looking very good in this ballgame.
You said blocking, flying to the football. Coaches always use that, don't they?
They really do. It's almost as, it goes back to the old, when they click off the frame at the end of a play, they must see all 11 defensive guys in that picture.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Being chased at left.
downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
They come up with an offset eye. Or he'll try again on second down. Let's try again. He's taken down. Danny Trevathan in there to drop him. And it'll be a loss of about eight.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
The upper defensive guy. Now it's a quarterback third long. You really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you're doing a big win. What else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because things are running pretty well.
Now Brady. And he couldn't corral it. It falls down incomplete, but maybe not a big deal given this big lead.
You know, it's not an easy job to drive catch passes if people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's the pass he's got to have, and the pass he should have caught.
Here's Ryan Allen now. On, we think, to punt, though he's faked it earlier, but he was unsuccessful. Here on the play clock. Brady now on first down. And he could hang on. dead second down.
Well, Nick, if we pass over, it doesn't look like a big play. For the guy throwing it today, as many interceptions he's thrown, he's going to feel a sigh of relief that the ball actually hit the ground and didn't go in the other direction.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play, now it's second down. They slide Gronkowski out right. Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. And off his back foot, it's caught at the 10. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. A nice shot there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
This time from the 7. Brady's going to look to throw. And they don't get it. They tried for the 2-point conversion there, but unsuccessful. Interesting call there. They went for 2 even after the penalty from the 7-yard line. It didn't pay off.
I think the first thought is to go ahead and kick the extra point. But you're not kicking it from the 7-yard line.
Yeah, right? That's not the snap. Five back on the PAT as well.
Right, so they have to take it from the 15 to administer the penalty. So now you're kicking it around 40 yards. So I understand why they probably went for 2 there. They thought they had a better play and a better chance in that situation.
Gostkowski now, after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. Let's feel it a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield, as he gears up to go again. He is fully awake now. If he didn't get off to the start that he normally does, they got his attention. He's running it well.
You think they set off the alarm clock at the half? That's the word down. I know he does. I mean, playing on the defensive side of the ball, if you do a really good job, you have a great runner. And you go into the half, you're excited, you're fired up, you think the game plan is working, but in the back of your head is that little bit of nagging doubt. Can we do this for more quarters? So far, that's not happening.
And the offense moving in the wrong direction here now as they face a 2nd and 12. They isolate Jeffrey to the left side. Now cover is rolling, 2nd down. There incomplete. Eddie Royal is intended target, and it's 3rd down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say the pressure could get to any quarterback.
And he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Defensively, a down look here. 6 DBs on 3rd and 12.
No surprise at all.
On 3rd down, Cutler. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. So he will have touchdown yardage as he's brought down at the 41. And he goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Give him credit there. The offensive play caller said that the screen pass was available. If you get a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. They work very well there for a first down.
On 1st and 10, it's Cutler. Cutler with a catch left side. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Back now here on EA Sports. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. Fresh set of downs here.
Conversion there on fourth down, and now they get 4 more shots from there.
and the seemingly endless drive continues. From the gun, it's Kepler. A close one there, incomplete.
Or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Second and goal from the 2-yard line. And he's in to the end zone. Touchdown Bears. Jordan Howard. His second touchdown in the Super Bowl. And the Bears get a bit closer. Now he's doing his part, but still facing a sizable deficit.
And he would like to do more. But he needs help from the other two-thirds, right? He needs his defense to blow up a little bit. And he also needs special teams to maybe create some big plays and help them get back in it.
So the defense gets the stop. I know it's situation to situation, but who has more pressure there, offense or defense, when they go for two?
I actually believe the defense has more pressure because the offense has an entire playbook wide open from the 2-yard line. You can run it, you can throw it. So defensively, I think most teams are going to be aggressive and force the issue and try and bring pressure.
And this is secured by the Patriots. And down big here in the fourth, they had to try the onside kick. In.
Changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Brady.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. Yards. Defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keep in the football.
And now, first down following that long game. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Brady now on first down. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Looking for his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski, and it's second down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will obviously break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
10 yards still left on second down. They slide Gronkowski outright. Looking back to the air on second down. It's Brady. Right side, caught, broken. That'll get to the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down.
Pass complete, but no gain.
4 yards.
Yeah. based on the stats, throwing the ball,
you get a completion.
You get a catch.
Yeah.
But still,
no yardage.
Okay.
Scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They'll go for it. It's Brady. That is incomplete. But it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Bears will get the football back. So they were really trying to put the nail in the coffin there already with this lead here in the fourth. But they didn't get it.
Guaranteed. It's not going to be a fun handshake in the postgame, right? You just know that there's going to be some bad blood there. And I know if we go to the postgame press conferences, the winning coach, you know what he's going to say? Why he did it? We need the points, okay? Because you never know at the end of the year if points are going to come into the tiebreaker if we're trying to get into the playoffs. That always is getting your justification.
On first down, it's Cutler. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Getting late in the fourth now, Charles. 2 minute warning just around the corner.
Yeah, some teams just want to get to that spot, take a breath, and then come out and attack for the rest of the game.
Again on second and 10, it's Cutler. Completion left side to Miller. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And the lead is trimmed down to 10. One play, two plays, touchdown. That's all it took there. A very short and sweet drive that got him in the end zone. And this is secured by the Patriots. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, we knew, even before they put the tanks of the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to nine. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. Getting down to the end here, they had a two-score lead, barely, but it's a two-score lead, so it probably makes your coach feel a lot more comfortable right now, doesn't it, Charles?
It does, but it doesn't mean now you go out and run option or something wild, double reverse or anything like that. But you do know that if anything goes the haywire, you're still in control of this game.
I want a double reverse, don't you? We'll see what happens here. Brady gonna look to throw. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Julian Edelman, the intended receiver, and that'll make it third down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they got completion, and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. Now Brady. So the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field. To throw is Green. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And that's going to be caught. Patriot touchdown. Julian Edelman, his second touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Patriots add on to their lead.
It would be real easy to say that they have primary control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking, I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't get a big thing cheap and easy. Not the coach, Jesse Jefferson.
The one after time for Gostkowski. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. So that drive of four plays, and it's finished on a five-pass touchdown. Gostkowski now, after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. Let's feel it a few yards into the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for five.
Some people like to do that. I've never played for a guy who was ruled out huge. If there was a coach, what do you want to call it? He's way behind the guys. Who cares? If they're out here, I can adjust something some other time. But some teams like to do something in the end to feel a little bit better.
Yeah.
And they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. They're probably just trying to get rolling. And we go down right around the 47 this time. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And now they're in the hurry up. On first and 10, it's Cutler. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds as they were. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course, you gotta keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Second down of the offense in search of 6 yards. Again, it's Cutler. He's got to be taken down here. Back across midfield, 3 yards away from midfield at the 47. Big sack on second down. Now the offense needs to convert here on third. On third down, Cutler. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Oh, a ball's headed in the air, and now it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line.
Well, you're trailing in the fourth quarter, and you've got to throw the football. But the defense knows this, too. So they're just going to sit back, bring in extra defensive backs for Tribune. Nick or time strategy, Brandon, and wait for you to put that bad boy up for grabs. And this one winds up being intercepted.
Patriots gearing up to go now. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you score a run, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. And no matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But 8 yards on first down puts them back on their heels.
Again, here's Blunt. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. And it's another Super Bowl title for the New England. And when this moment comes, I think you look back at all the blood, sweat, and tears, the offseason, the workout.